So the second question, he had an argument with somebody that we have knowledge, and with our logic we can realize what is right and what is wrong, and we can be judgmental of things and so on. We don't need to rely on the views of the earlier generations. And the person means by that, you know, whether the companions or at-tabi'een and their followers and so on. But this comes in clear contradiction with the guidance of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Because when you say that, yeah, people will be divided into many sects, many groups, and all of them will be astray except for one group, then the companions obviously asked him, who will be those people who will remain steadfast, maintaining new traditions, and will be representing the mainstream ummah? He said, those will be following whatever I and my companions are doing today. So we find ourselves obliged to follow them in the religious matters, okay? And that's why when you study fiqh, you say, like nowadays, in order to make any statement concerning the COVID-19, you say the World Health Organization said, or the Ministry of Health said. In the deen, you're going to say, the Prophet ﷺ said, or any of the companions said in a sound hadith. So without them, basically there is no religion. So we're obliged to follow the guidance of the Prophet and his chosen companions, whom Allah the Almighty praised and made them superior, and chose them to be the companions of the Prophet ﷺ. مَنْ عَلَمَ أَنَا عَلَيْهِ الْيَوْمَ وَأَصْحَابِي. Forget about the world which is annoying you. Stop calling them the predecessors or whatever. Just call them the companions and the followers and the followers of the followers. Isn't this what the Prophet ﷺ said? He said, خَيْرُ النَّاسِ قَرْنِي ثُمَّ الَّذِينَ يَلُونَهُمْ ثُمَّ الَّذِينَ يَلُونَهُمْ. The best of people at large, my companions, and the next generation and the next generation, which are known as Sahaba, Tabi'een, and Tabi'i at-Tabi'een. And I explained before the meaning of each one of those terms.